Good evening, everybody. Thanks for coming tonight. This is our winter jazz festival. Seems like we just got back to school, and we did. But we always do this early in the semester, and we're very pleased once again to have our station and Prairie Jazz Bands join us for this evening. So we'll start with Mr. Sorsen and, of course, Station Jazz Band. And it featured our 8th grade tenor saxophonist, Mr. Drew Meyer. I'm going to make a quick correction to our program tonight. The second selection, Six Shooter, we're not going to do that one. We're going to save that for another time. But our last tune of the evening is Soul Man. We hope this one's going to get your toes tapping. So enjoy. Soul Man. Probably don't need to tell you this, but it is in your program. But I would like to welcome our newest addition to our District 220 band department, Mrs. Timonello. And the Prairie Campus Jazz Band.
Thank you. thank you so much. We are going to conclude our portion of tonight's concert with a tune called Work Song. And before we skedaddle off stage, I just want to say thank you so much to Mr. Karen and to the lovely facilities here at BHS, as well as the gracious high school students for inviting us all, both on behalf of Station as well as Prairie, to come tonight and share this concert with you on this lovely, little bit chilly winter's night, but that's okay. The snow's not that bad quite just yet. So thank you again very much. Parents, thank you so much for your support and getting these students to and from rehearsals and practices and all sorts of stuff. They're so talented, not just in music. So thank you for supporting them in all of their endeavors, but especially music. So thank you. So we will finish tonight's portion of the concert with a tune called Work Song.
Thank you.
How about another big hand for our guest, Station Terry. Thank you. So we're continuing with our jazz ensemble combo, and this is our seventh hour. We meet seventh hour during the day. We have been exploring, I guess, since kind of the before winter break, and now after, just a couple weeks past that. But also, we have a new member, so we decided just let's just kind of continue the songs that we're exploring. So it all kind of comes from the same era of jazz. So that would be mid to the late 1960s into the up to about 1973-ish. So and they're different, but there's a lot of similarities between the songs. So rather than I don't need to announce the songs, you have programs in your hands. But rather than me announcing each tune, I think I'm just going to talk about them now, and then we'll play those songs. We'll take breaks in between each one, but whenever you feel as though you would like to applaud for any of these gentlemen up here, please do, because they're all going to be playing melodies and solos, and it's not free form by any means, but everybody is going to be soloing on everything, so that's unique. So the era, the type of music that we're doing, you might be familiar with it. It's kind of soul jazz and funk jazz. So and you notice that we begin with a Herbie Hancock piece and we end with a Herbie Hancock piece. They weren't so different in terms of years, but they were different in terms of the way Herbie Hancock approached those. Of course, Herbie Hancock's just a legend, still alive, still doing a lot of things musically. So we start with that, more of a soulful type Herbie Hancock composition. And then we end with something that's a little bit more on the funk side, where he kind of incorporated a lot of electronic keyboards and sounds into his music. And if you're familiar with that, this is more along the line of the Headhunters album, which was the mid-70s, the early to mid-70s, and then his Maiden Voyage album was the first song. And then in between, we got a tune by the great Eddie Harris, the saxophone player, and what else did we have? I'm forgetting the other. Oh, right, yeah. And another very seminal pianist, Joe Zawinul, wrote Mercy, 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 which was recorded earlier. We're going to do like an earlier version of that. And then there's many, many awesome versions of Mercy, Mercy, Mercy. But so those three composers and musicians. So I'll announce our players here now. So we have William over there on keyboard. And then Graham, who's going to get back to you, not on purpose. And we've got Manav. And then our newest member, he's only been with us for a couple of weeks, but does an awesome job on drums, Isai, on drums. So here we go with our soul and funk set.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
That was Sai on alto. Yeah. Sai's going to play another solo on our next song, as well as Mr. Egan back there on trumpet. And this is, these guys kept telling me, because we started working on this before winter break, so this is a Christmas song. This one. So, no, it's not a Christmas song. It doesn't have anything to do with Christmas, really. It just has to do with the fact that Thad Jones, famous composer and trumpeter, and very famous jazz musician from the 30s, 40s, 50s, and on, had to do with the birth of his children. So I think his first child. So that's where this title comes from. It's normally a very beautiful kind of waltzy ballad, and we start out that way, but this has all kinds of twists and turns in it, changes feel. And I really like this arrangement. So again, we got Sai and Egan, and this is A Child Is Born. Thank you. Okay, so I'm old enough to know when there wasn't these things and computers and the internet and all kinds of YouTube and everything else. So I told this to the band and they were, you know, enthralled with this story. Really, they were enraptured. Really. So anyway, the story behind this piece and many pieces that we have in our library here, Cartagena, it's written by a man named Steve Spiegel, who's a very talented composer and trumpet player, and he has a big band. I believe he's still alive. I don't know if his big band is still going. You can probably look it up on YouTube. But he used to, back in the 20th century, he used to travel all over the country for a few months of the year, and he literally had his, you know, his briefcase and recordings, and when he first started showing up, it was like a Sony Walkman with a cassette. Here's this song. But he'd call me up on the telephone. Yeah, that, one of those. Before they had, you know, it would be the one you had to plug into the wall and, you know, that kind of thing. Might have even had a rotary dial, I'm not sure. I think it probably did, believe it or not. But he would call me up on the phone and say, hey, I'm going to be in the Chicago area, I'm going to see so-and-so. Can I come by after school on whatever day? I said, yeah, sure, come on by. It's just about every 5 years he would come by and he'd say, well, I wrote this song and I think this would be great. And I wrote this song and this would be wonderful. And so I'd listen to the songs and they'd say, okay, we'll buy this and this and this. And then, you know, he would send the pieces to me, you know, when he got back home to California. And that's the way it worked. It was just kind of like traveling salesman. Here are my wares. So he would come by. So this is one of those pieces, Cartagena, by Steve Spiegel. And he had all kinds of different music and varied in difficulty. And it was great. So that was, you know, before you could just, you know, look it up on the website and then order it, and you could have it electronically sent to you in 10 seconds. But yeah, that's the story behind this piece. So on this one, Cy's gonna play another solo. He didn't know that until just right now. And then also Brady on trombone is gonna play a solo. So this is Cartagena, and you can imagine it's not a swing tune. So it's gonna start out with Abby on guitar. She's gonna play this little melodic idea for us. So this is Cartagena. Thank you. So before we, this is our last piece, as you can see from the program. I don't have to tell you that. You already know that. However, I would mention, once again, thank you to our Prairie and Station guests. You guys are awesome. And please, when you get to high school, and I know most of you won't be here for another year or two, please, these are awesome groups. This is the opportunity to play in jazz groups such as this. It doesn't happen everywhere, so it's pretty unique. You get this opportunity. You're playing an instrument. This is where you want to be, band, jazz band. Sign up for these groups. It's an awesome experience. If you have any questions, parents or you guys, about what high school and what you should be signing up for and how this works, these are both our ensemble and this group. These are classes during school, so not jazz in the curriculum is a very wonderful and unique thing, and it's a great opportunity that we have here at Barrington High School. So please take advantage of that. These are great groups. So anyway, that being said, our last piece requires me to do something that I will try to keep up with these guys with. So I'm going to go back to the drum set. Whew. Craziness. Because our drummer is also an outstanding piano player. He kind of alternates between piano and drums. So Benjamin is over there on piano, and he's going to play a solo. In fact, he's the first soloist on this. And then we have a whole bunch of solos on this. And this is the Woogie. It's kind of a fun piece. And it's written by a fantastic trombonist by the name of Wycliffe Gordon. These trombone players all know Wycliffe Gordon. He's awesome. So does Mr. Searcy and probably everybody else in here. But of course, we've got some trombone solos. Calvin's going to play a solo. Brady's going to play a solo. And then trumpets are going to play a solo. Matt's got a solo. Liam's got a solo. Nathan over there on tenor sax is going to play a solo. Danny's going to play a solo. Savannah's going to play a solo. No, I'm just kidding. That's what I'm going to say. Anyway, Danny's going to play a solo on this as well. So thank you for coming, and we'll see you down the road. Our next big performance with our jazz groups is down in our CAF, if we still have one, by April. And that's our job in jazz, so please join us for that and anything else that we have performances for coming up. Okay, so this is the Woogie. Thanks again for coming. Thank you.